Good evening, everyone. I am Dr. Wolf, and I just got back from watching Thor Ragnarok. I've actually been looking forward to this for quite some time because Marvel has been on such a high streak for so long. I can't remember the last time I've watched one of their movies where it turned out to be only just okay. Now, I can remember way back many years ago watching the first Thor movie and thinking that, yeah, it was good enough. I'd never watched the second one, but from the reviews I heard, I suppose I wasn't missing all that much. But from everything that they've been doing in the past few years, it seems like every single Marvel movie has been getting better and better with their writing, especially with the jokes, especially with the stories, especially with the ending conflicts. I can remember, especially in the past couple of years, my favorite Marvel film has been Civil War, and my favorite Marvel superhero has been Doctor Strange. And in this case, Thor Ragnarok, it shares a number of similarities with both of those films, which I'll get into later. To start with, Thor Ragnarok, a couple of characters that we know from past films, like Thor, and from anyone who's been watching the trailers, the Hulk. Now, the Hulk hasn't been seen ever since Avengers 2. The fact that he's suddenly on this planet that's kind of this junk heap that Thor ends up on, and they end up brawling with each other and just poking fun at one another. The dialogue that they come up with between these characters is actually really clever and creative and definitely keeps you enjoying every moment. But they keep a lot of the dialogue as the Hulk, not as Bruce Banner, the character. And they haven't done that in any of the Marvel films up to this point. And that's an interesting take to go with the movies that they've done so far. You never explore the character of the Hulk, but now you get to see Thor. He's trying to encourage the Hulk to be on his side, while at the same time trying to bring Bruce Banner out, and then kind of weighing in between. I'm trying not to go into heavy spoilers because I'm trying to keep this more spoiler-free, but it gets to be interesting to see the dialogue between how he weighs against the Hulk and how they keep putting each other down while still having fun with each other at the same time. I will say that, as you've probably seen in the trailers already, Loki does make a return, and like so many people have mentioned before, Loki tends to be one of those villains throughout the entire Marvel movies that is one of the very few that tends to be memorable, that tends to be really fun, that tends to be what the audience wants to see making a return. And I'm glad that he's here, and I'm glad that he's doing his thing, but he's not the main villain here. He's kind of a side character, and he is definitely welcome. I am glad that he's still doing his thing with Thor, where they are constantly suspicious of one another, and you're constantly questioning what his real motives are, and they play his character very well here. But the main villain is actually played by Cate Blanchett. And I don't know, I think this might be one of those few Marvel villains that actually does leave a bit more of an impact. I'll go back and watch the film again one of these weeks. She actually had more of an intimidating presence. She was certainly better acted than most other Marvel villains because, hey, it's Cate Blanchett. But I think her dialogue was better. I think she had much more of a needed purpose in the story. And I like what they did with her in the beginning, in the middle, and especially at the end of the film. I won't go into what they did with her, but I really like the direction they took with her character and how she interacted with Thor and how Thor was able to overcome her character, Hela, in the end. Because much like another one of the Marvel films that I've really enjoyed, Doctor Strange, there were certain parts of Doctor Strange, much like with Thor Ragnarok, where it looks like they're gonna go in a certain direction. It looks like they're gonna go over certain number of cliche moments, especially towards the ending conflict, where you start thinking to yourself, really? They're gonna do this? I mean, it looks like it'll be fun, but you've seen this built up in so many other films, it kind of seems it's gonna be a bit of a slog to get through. But then they kind of turn it on its head, and you realize that they've been setting something up from earlier on in the film that you didn't realize they were setting up. And when it all starts fitting together and it suddenly clicks and you're like, oh wait, oh that's clever. Oh, that's really creative. I like that. I'm glad that they put that in there. I love the fact that they are coming up with Marvel films that kind of throw you for a loop, that have these engaging stories that come and go, but at the end really pull you back in, that really say to yourself, I did not see that coming. That's really clever. I really like that. There are way too many movies these days that are just far too predictable to the point where, yeah, I know exactly where it's gonna go, but I hope we're gonna have a lot of fun getting there. I much prefer having a movie where you have a lot of fun getting there and you don't always know where it's coming. And Thor Ragnarok, at least for the ending, definitely threw me for a loop and definitely kept me entertained. Now, I will add a few caveats in that there are parts of the movie, just parts of the movie, where it feels like it really slows down and there's some stretches where you're not sure how long it's going to take before things start picking up again and you start scratching your head and you're like, are they going to be doing anything? I mean, some of the dialogue is good, but I feel like they're not quite sure where to take the story, like they're kind of dragging things out a little too long here and there. It doesn't last too long. There's just short 5-10 minute segments here and there throughout the film where you start to think maybe they're running out of ideas about where to take the story or how to fill up the time. But it does pick up again. It's just a little noticeable that they didn't have a full story to fill out the entire runtime. But it is enough of a story to keep you engaged throughout much of the film. And I do appreciate that. And I very much appreciate the fact that when they're going from world to world and all these different environments, it looks amazing. It's really colorful, it's exquisitely detailed, and it's a visual marvel, of course. That's just expected. But I don't know. I feel like there are pieces of the action where I've seen probably better in other Marvel films. Civil War definitely comes to mind. Again, probably my favorite of all the Marvel films out there, so that's a pretty high bar. But I can also think back to other films like the original Avengers or even Avengers 2, where I think that the action that they put in those films was much more fun. Much more, hey, I want to watch that again. And I can't really think of any action set pieces except maybe for the fight between Thor and Hulk in the big arena that I'd want to go back and watch again. Maybe just that one. So, yeah, the action is good, but suppose I've come to expect a little bit more from watching Marvel films these days. Maybe it's the fact that Marvel has been spoiling us for so long that they keep setting the bar pretty high. But like I've said before, the dialogue is consistently fun. I think they've learned over the years that the comedy gets better and better from pretty much every film they put together. Of the three films this year, Guardians of the Galaxy 2, Spider-Man Homecoming, and Thor Ragnarok, I'd say that Spider-Man Homecoming is probably my favorite of the three, but Guardians of the Galaxy 2 and Thor Ragnarok, I think those two are pretty close seconds. I'm not sure which one is better. And I definitely say that it's worth watching on the big screen because, like I said, a visual treat to see. And the story, while slow at times, it does throw you for a loop in places. and it definitely keeps you engaged. And you do want to see where it's going, and the characters are definitely a lot of fun to watch. The theater erupted in laughter many, many times, and I was certainly among them. So, definitely a lot of fun. I would probably say that it's worth watching in the theater, but it was definitely very full, considering that I went to see it on the opening weekend, so you may wish to wait a little while to go see it yourself if you don't want to sit all the way in the front row like I had to. But it is worth a watch, and it is definitely a lot of fun. And I look forward to seeing what other Marvel films they've got coming up in the near future, because they're drawing close to the Infinity War next year. And I've been waiting long, long time to see that. But I appreciate what they've done, and I'm eagerly awaiting what they have in store next. Until next time, I am Dr. Wolf, and I look forward to hearing from you.